Today's topic is stomatal apparatus. A brief introduction of a stomatal apparatus will be given here in this lecture. Before going through what is a stomatal apparatus, first of all, we should know what is stomata. If we see a plant leaf, it contains several tiny pores which are present on its surface. These pores are not visible through naked eyes. These tiny pores are called as stomata. The main functions of stomata in plants are transpiration, that is, loss of water from the plant, and second, it is gaseous exchange, which is important for respiration as well as photosynthesis. Now let's see the detailed structure of a stomata. A stomata contains a small tiny pore in the center. This pore is called as stomatal aperture, or simply it is called as stoma. Surrounding this stoma are present two bean-shaped cells which are called as guard cells, which have their own nucleus. These cells are called as guard cells as they help in the opening and closing of the stomata. Surrounding these guard cells are present large-sized cells which are called as subsidiary cells. These cells are large in size as they have all the gases which are exchanged through stomata, whether they are getting in or whether they are getting out. The stomatal apparatus constitute together constitute stoma, guard cells, plus the subsidiary cells. These are together called as stomatal apparatus. The guard cells, apart from the nucleus, also carries tiny green structures. These are called as chloroplast. Chloroplast is a cell organelle that carries out photosynthesis. So this was a very simple structure of a stomatal apparatus. In my next lecture, I'll be telling you more specifications about the stomata and its present in various types of plant. Thank you.